room that has squeaks in certain areas of the room. What other options do I have other than injecting epoxy on the individual boards?
What options do you have other than injecting epoxy on the boards on the squeaks?
Yes.
Flood?
What?
Flood?
Flood?
That'll take care of it. No, I'm kidding on that one, please. I'm sorry, some of you don't know my sense of humor, so I apologize for that. You got squeaks out, and I'm assuming if you're injecting, you are talking about a glue-down concrete type scenario. Is that correct? Squeaks, you got to break that down first. Squeaks means you have vertical movement. For some of you, I lived a lot of years in East Tennessee, so I talk funny. All right, vertical movement means up and down. You have to describe that to some people sometimes. You cannot have squeaks unless you have vertical movement up and down. Why do you have vertical movement up and down? Maybe a hollow spot or a depression in the subfloor, which can be injected with a adhesive. Alternative to that would be a board replacement. That was the question, was it not, John? What is the alternative other than injection?
Correct.
Well, you can't set the piano on it, but that would work. Mm-hmm. If it's on concrete, but usually if the injection system's not acceptable, you're going to have to do a partial replacement or board replacement in that general area. However, if you take one out and put one in, did you fix the problem? So we have to identify first, before any corrective action's done, what is the problem? If you're in a concrete slab, I don't know what the most of you is. I have seen that also in, which I don't understand myself, but that's just because I'm cheap. Glue down over plywood. I have seen some D-lam because sometimes a plywood wasn't sufficiently dry, or it was too dry or too wet, and you can get squeaks from the subfloor. Was it nailed properly? No cross bracing underneath. Injection in that scenario probably would not work. Then you're going to have to probably go underneath with some screws, cross bracing, or remove a board, screw the floor down from the top, put the board back in if it's on a plywood type subfloor. So it kind of depends on what you've got, what part of the country you've got. And if you do a board replacement, please don't do what I did the first time. Leave it out in the truck in the summer. Go in the air-conditioned house, pull a board out, and wonder why the board's too big to go in the hole. Explain to the nice lady in this $400,000 house, you'll be back tomorrow. Does not go over well, I guarantee you.